are taking a look at Jigsaw Puzzle Blues by Fleetwood Mac. I'm going to walk you through the rhythm guitar part played by Peter Green behind Danny Kirwan's searing solo work. Even if you intend to learn the guitar solo, it'd be really useful for you to learn the rhythm guitar part as a foundation, and that'll help you understand what's going on with the solo a lot better in terms of the arpeggios and things used. Okay, so let's go on. There are four sections to this, four different keys. The first one is D minor, and then we're going to move to the key of A major, E major, and finish up in B minor. And what that means is that the D minor and the B minor final section are both pretty much exactly the same, just in different key. So that makes things a little easier. So let's start off with the first section. D minor, 5th fret, bar chord. So that's basically how it goes. Solid strums, 4 to the bar, downward strums. And we've got B flat 7 to A7. Okay. Now, you can just play the full bar chords if you wish. Okay, that's one way to do it. Another way, I like to play the full bar chord on the first chord. And then when I change, I go to this three-note voicing. Sounds like this. Okay, and notice that I use these rear fingers to make that B-flat 7. The reason for that is the pinky is already where it needs to be. It's on the third of B-flat, right there. The ring finger just needs to move across one fret, like so. We get rid of the index finger as the middle finger steps up to the B-flat bass. So all of that together goes like that. So it's a very small movement to make that chord change. And it's also a three-note chord voicing. So I'm muting this string incidentally with the middle finger, and I'm only strumming through those four strings. So it's a much tighter chord than this. A lot more noise. So it leaves a bit more room for the rhythm section, the bass and the drums, to fill that space. Okay, so we play through that whole sequence repeating 4 times, and on the final time we're going to go E flat, 2 beats, up to E, ready for the key change to A. The E being the 5 chord in relation to the new key of A. All right. So let's just play through that section slowly. Okay, and we're into A. We've got 2 bars of A, but instead of our solid 1, 2, 3, 4 count that we had previously, we're switching to a more open kind of feel here, because the rhythm section opens up, the bass is playing a more open bass line. So we're going to go on the bass end of the chord, 1, and then 2 and as a strum down on the high end, and then bass on 3, and then strum again here. So it sounds like this. Sorry. You don't have to do it exactly like that, but just to show there's a difference between that and this. Okay? So we play two bars of that, and then there's a bass break. Leave that space for the bass, okay? And we're going to move from there into a D9. So let's just play those opening 2 bars of A moving forward. D9. Okay, so let's backtrack through some of that. So we had our swing, bars of A, space for the bass, 1, 2, 3, 4, D9, straight 4s, then swing in A. Then straight fours on E9. Sharp, back, and then that sequence of A, A7, D major, D minor. One beat per chord there. Okay, so here from the E9, we've got a bar of E9. One, two, three, four. Then two beats on the F9. Two beats on the E, and then we're into this sequence. And it's one beat per chord here. A, A7, D, D minor. So just practice that slowly. Two beats each at the end there on A to B7. Okay, and then we're into the key of E. Bass line. Back to A. See the second section exactly the same as the third section, just in the key of A and E respectively. Okay, so let's backtrack through that E section slowly. We start off the same as the A section with the swing in E part, nice and open. Space for the bass. 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. Back to A. B flat diminished. Back to E. Two bars. Then B9, sharp, flat, and then that sequence. E, E7, A, A minor, E, F sharp. So that again. Okay, and that takes us into the final section, B minor. So notice there again, I'm not playing, this is a G7, right? G7, not playing that, and I'm not playing G7 here, to F7, F sharp 7, because that would sound too full, too busy. So I'm playing a full one chord, and I'm really emphasizing the high strings to give it that punch and drive in line with the rhythm section, really driving it home for the last part. So. Then again, I'm pulling back on those other chords by playing the three note voicings and also by shifting the bass up. So this is a G7 here, 10th fret, 9th fret, 10th fret, there's the G root on the middle finger. We're going to move that root up a string to D, so we get a G/D, a G with a D on the bass. And that leaves the space for the bass to fill, where the bass can play the root note if it wishes, or around it. And we're not occupying that space. And also with the three note voicing, as I said before, it's just a little bit more refined sound. So sounds like this. Okay, so I hope that helps. I look forward to jamming this with you next week. Enjoy. I'll see you then. Cheers.